I came to Port Alberni to visit my friend Rick Schiewink. I met Rick in 1976 in my hometown. He was a young hockey player. I promised him one day I would come and visit him. It took me 27 years to come and visit Rick on Vancouver Island. Rick was from Port Alberni, so we decided to settle here. First we thought of a house, but we bought a beautiful lot in Cherry Creek in the woods. That's pretty special for a Dutch girl to find 5 acres to build a house on. So we built a beautiful home and here we are, and I love it. If life treats you well, it's time to give something back. And since the community was treating me very well by being so friendly and welcoming, I thought it was about time that I would go and do something and give back to this community. So I started volunteering. In 2007, I started organizing fundraising activities for the Alberni Valley Hospice Society. They were preparing to open Vancouver Island's first hospice house called Ty Watson House. As a young adult, I had taken care of my mother who died of cancer, and I understood the importance of end-of-life care very well. Ty Watson House opened in January of 2008. It's a beautiful renovated house with 5 bedrooms, staffed by a group of incredible volunteers who, together with home care nurses, provide the care and support for residents as they near the end of their lives. But that was just the beginning. In order to survive, Ty Watson House needed money, and lots of it. With no government funds for operating costs, Ty Watson House was depending on donations and fundraising events. Gaming grants were scaled back and nonprofits were competing for funding. Everyone was being asked to dig deeper into their pockets. We started basic fundraising in the community, everything from raffles and bake sales to car washes and knocking on doors of local business owners asking for their help. After a couple of years of organizing different fundraisers, I started looking for another solution. There had to be a better and more sustainable way to support a local charity like Ty Watson House. I thought if I could find a way to let the organization and their resources like staff and funds and volunteers do what they want to do and concentrate on their mission, then maybe we can find another way to raise the funds for them in a different organization, maybe through a business. The business I had in my mind could help supporting nonprofits like Ty Watson House by donating a big portion of the profit to the charity.
Anyone who knows me knows that I have a love for sport and a passion for coaching youth. What they might not know about me is my commitment to the concept of hospice care and our very own Ty Watson House. So when Helma told me she wanted to start a new business, I thought, great idea. But then when she told me the business would be giving most of its profit to charity, well, let's just say the conversations got interesting.
I was really serious. I was committed to this idea, so I started to look for the business. What could it be? And one day it hit me. The answer was sitting right in front of me in our very own house. When I immigrated to Canada, I brought my favorite collection of ceramic cookware that I use in my kitchen every day. That was the light bulb going off. My ceramics were made in a small factory in Spain, in the northeast of Spain. And I had bought them during my many visits to Catalonia, to this area. So I told Rick, we should go and check this out. We should go to Spain. Finding a structure for potluck was a challenge. I knew a lady from my Pilates class, that was Val's startup. And Val had expressed that she loved the way I was doing the fundraising for Ty Watson House. She wanted to get involved with Ty Watson House and she would love to work with me. So I thought maybe I should write Val an email and see how she responds to this idea.
I read Helma's email and it all just clicked. I signed on right away. It was a very exciting idea that I wanted to be part of right from the start. The idea of creating a business designed to help fund charities seemed like a really interesting idea, but we didn't know how to set up a business structure to make that happen. Helma and I worked all summer creating the 170 rules and the memorandum of agreement. There was so much more to this than we had ever dreamed, but we enjoyed this new challenge.
We ended up creating a really unique and innovative business structure by incorporating a community service co-op, which we named the Port Alberni Fundraising Co-op. The co-op would raise funds for local charities by owning and operating a ceramics business. Potluck would be owned and controlled by its co-op members.
We now have the base for our new venture. This way, we can donate up to 75% of our net profit to charity before taxes through the Port Alberni Fundraising Co-op. Those are the salad bowls and those are the fruit bowls. Oh. This is more a shallow kind of. Rick and I went to Spain to visit the ceramic factories in La Bisbal, a small industrial town in Catalonia.
I in fact ordered all cutters. First, I didn't think of it, but when...
We found exactly the kind of products we were looking for. Beautiful terracotta ceramics that they would custom design for us, incorporating images from Vancouver Island into their traditional glazes and finishes. We decided to order from three different family-owned factories and spent the rest of our visit working out the details of importing bulk shipment to Port Alberni.
Well, originally we looked for a bricks and mortar storefront location, but in the end opted to upgrade our recently constructed barn-style building on our property in Cherry Creek. The shelving went up last week and we feel ready to receive and warehouse the 22-pallet shipment set to arrive this weekend.
Potluck Ceramics is probably the most exciting thing I've ever done, but I have to keep telling myself that it's just part of a bigger picture. We need to make Potluck a successful business so that it, in turn, can help fund Ty Watson House and, in the future, help other nonprofit organizations in the Alberni Valley.
Yes, Potluck is ambitious, but it's also really, really exciting. It's a new approach, and I'm curiously optimistic about what this business will and can become. One thing's for sure, it's a positive step towards helping sustain a very worthwhile community service.
This is the one we designed. We designed this one, hey? That's our design. I just love it. It became so beautiful.
The designs range from traditional Catalonian folk art to the more modern. We have over 80 different items in several sizes and colors.
Come on, look at the salmon.
We also wanted something more unique to Vancouver Island and the West Coast, something that would have a strong local appeal for tourists. Helma and I worked with the designers in Spain to develop our own signature series that reflects our lifestyle here, the West Coast. Everything from dinnerware inspired by the surf, to eagles and orcas, salmon, and even bear tracks.
Attention to Port Alberni, BC.
Eventually, we hope to manufacture the West Coast series right here in Port Alberni and make it a true local product.
Ty Watson House has supported almost 80 residents since it opened its doors in 2008. It has an incredibly dedicated group of people, both staff and volunteers, who need our financial support so that they can focus on their mission and do what they do best as caregivers to those most in need. Potluck can help realize this goal for hospice and for other nonprofits.
Potluck Port Alberni.
Port Alberni, BC.
Non-profit.
We look forward to Potluck, our new business venture, and to being a part of the revitalization of Port Alberni, this great place we call home.